from Rescue Community Church, and every one of us, no matter how poor, no matter how rich, no matter how healthy, no matter how sick, are dealing with the reality of a virus that we can't control. And that's frustrating. We have to wear a mask. We have to get 6 feet plus apart from each other. It can become very frustrating, at least for people like us who like to have control of situations. Most of us are familiar with a market, the stock market, how we would love to control it, to know its algorithms so we could have all this money and be really rich. But if you're like everybody, mostly in America, it just doesn't happen overnight, you know? And then there's the relationship deal where you have a husband, you have a wife, a boyfriend, girlfriend, a parent and child, or whatever kind of relationship it is, that you just wished if you could control the other person. Because if you could control the other person, then they would be great. They would do what you want them to do. And there would be no arguments. There would be no fights. There would be no concern. And the relationship would be heavenly. But sadly, sadly, that is not what happens. When you look at the definition of control, it means the power to influence or direct people's behavior or the course of events. And so over the next few weeks, we will be looking at a group of people that were control freaks. And that is the people of Israel. They wanted to control their own life. They did not want to give their control over to God. They wanted to be the boss in every single aspect of their life. And sadly, it did not turn out well, like it does not turn out well for a lot of us. And what we do in our lives, whether it's our relationship with our families, our friends, whether it's our coworkers at work, whether it's our community members, whatever is going on in our life, I bet that your number one wish is that you could just be in control and everything would be better. And I bet also that a lot of times there comes that great moment where we get the control that we've always been wanting, and then we begin to exercise that control by just putting down the power on the people that we love. And when we put that power down on the people that we love, and then we twist it, and we twist it, and we twist it, and we twist the control that we have. But the problem is, because we're fallen people, because we make mistakes, we're not leading people in the right direction. And sometimes what we want is not always the best. And so as we twist it, and we twist it, and we twist it, all of a sudden, at some point, it has to go away. And boom. There's an explosion. So the explosion is either us getting really angry, freaking out, or it's either the people that we're dealing with get angry and freak out. And we wonder, how did this go wrong? And we realize that, you know what? Maybe we actually don't need control for our lives to be changed. And so that's the encouragement that I have for this sermon series coming up, and that you and I can realize that sometimes we can be kind of a control freak. And that if that's you and you want control of everything in your life and you try to micromanage everybody in your life, and that freaking out is not going to fix anything. And so tune in this Sunday and this coming weeks after that to discover how you can actually fix the problems in your life. How you can actually experience transformation in your relationships. How you can experience forgiveness of your sins. And the good news is, you don't have to be in charge of your whole life. So, therefore, it is possible. I look forward to hearing from you and sharing with you the great plan that God has for your life.